In this session, we're going to understand how exactly do you manage all the resources that have been generated using Power BI, and also how do you publish reports and share reports with colleagues and also free users. Now, for that, first you'll have to log in. First, you'll have to have an account, any licensing assigned to you. But once you have an account, this is the software as a service where the cloud service where you can actually publish your reports and data sets and also share the reports to different users. Okay, so this is called as cloud Power BI service. Okay, now the URL which you go to is app.powerbi.com, and once you go there, you just have to log in there. Okay, now once you log in there, okay, you should have a license, any license, even free license will do. Okay, so once you have it, you can actually publish the reports and share it with users among your organization. Okay, now with that being said, you can actually get a pro license for 2 or 3 months for free and try using this Power BI cloud service. Now, I have an account which is assigned by my organization, which is a pro account. Now, we'll go through we'll go through the different types of accounts and all. But I have an account which is a pro account. You can see that over here. Okay. Now, with that being said, what I can do is I can actually publish my report over here and share the changes with users from here. Okay. Now what I'll do is I'll just go to a report which I've been working on. Now this is the report which I've been working on. Just a single page report, single page which is sales, and the same data source which I've been using earlier. Okay, so this is the data source, sales data source which has customer, employee, location, measures table. Okay, measures table has total revenue and products and sales. Okay, I've done the modeling as well. I have established all the relationships. Okay, and I've also done, got this visualizations right over here. Okay, now this is just a card which will show all the revenue, total revenue, and customer name and the revenue which they have made, product name and the revenue that is made on that particular product, states and the revenue that is made in that particular state. Okay, and also line graph which actually shows the revenue that is made across years. Okay, so 2018, what is the revenue? Okay, 2017, what exactly is the revenue? Okay, 2019, what exactly is the revenue, and so on. And this is just a slicer which you can actually slice various products. Okay, to slice various products you have to hold control, which we already know. So if I just select various products, okay, if I just filter various products, I can see the products that are, the products and their cumulative revenue, the total revenue which is made by those products. And also you can see that the products, this particular guy has invested $4.58 on all those products. Maybe he has done more investments on other products, but yeah, that is how much he has invested on this product. Okay. Now, if you just click on this erase symbol, everything will be erased. Okay. Now, yeah. So this is the simple sales one-page report which I have created. Now, once you create the report, okay, you just whenever you want to publish it to your cloud service, which is Power BI service, okay, you'll have to click on this publish button and then publish it on your service. But before you do publishing and all, you should have the account and you'll have to sign in with that particular account over here. Okay, so this is the account and I have signed in with my account. Okay, now with that being said, now you'll just click on this publish. Okay, now this will actually ask you to publish. Okay, it will ask you if you want to save the changes and all. Yes, we want to save the changes if we have done any, so we are going to save it. Just control this. But before we publish, I want to publish it in a separate workspace. Now let's just go ahead and understand what exactly is a workspace. Okay. Now we have different workspaces. Now every user, every Power BI service user by default they get a workspace called my workspace, which is actually a default workspace for every user. Okay, now apart from that, users can actually create more workspaces as well, like how we did over here, which is Azure A2C, Deccan Soft Office Services, and RestRedX workspaces. Okay, you can actually create your own workspace. Now, what exactly is this workspace? Now, workspace is something, okay, that will actually hold your reports, data sets, and dashboards. Okay, now that is what is a workspace is. Okay, so workspace is something that will actually hold reports, data sets, and dashboards. Okay, now what exactly is a data set? Now, in our earlier classes, we have seen Power BI Live connection to a data set. Now, data set is something which is a combination of all these tables from a particular report. That is what is a data set is. Okay, so that is what is a data set. Okay. And then you have reports. Report is, this is one report where it is called a sales report. Okay. And inside sales report, the report can be made into multiple pages and can be made into multiple tiles. Okay. Each one is a tile or a visualization. Each visualization is a tile. Okay. Now, so that is what is report is. Now, what exactly is a dashboard? We'll see what exactly is a dashboard in a while, but let's just go here and try to create a new workspace, which is a collection of reports, dashboards, and data sets. Now, I'll just call this workspace as sales workspace. Okay. And you can actually have an image over here if you want, and you can have a description as well if you want. And apart from that, what you can do is contact list. People, whoever you share this workspace with, they'll have a button to contact people. Okay. Now, people can contact workspace admins whenever they have any queries regarding workspace or something. Or people can actually contact specific users if you choose to mention any users or groups over here. Okay. Now, that's up to you. Now, with that being said, there are a few licensing modes. Okay. And we'll talk about what exactly is this develop a template app. Okay. Not sure what exactly is this workspace OneDrive. Looks like it is a new one. I request you guys to go through it. But we'll talk through this licenses right now. Okay. So to licenses, let's just copy this and go through the licenses pricing. Now, there are actually, if you can see over here, there are actually four different licenses over here, which is Pro mode, Premium per user, Premium per capacity, and Embedded mode. Okay. But if you look at it over here, there are only three licenses, which is Power BI Pro and Power BI Premium per user and per capacity. Okay. Now, Power BI Pro is for this many dollars per month, and whereas Power BI User, Premium per user is this per month, and Power BI Premium per capacity is this per month. Okay, now what happens with this is there are a lot of things and features that you get with this Power BI licensing. Okay, now mobile app access, everyone has it. Publish reports to share and collaborate. Yes, Power BI Pro licenses. Guys with Power BI Pro license can also publish reports and share it. And so does all the other people. Okay. Now, there is something called paginated reports. Now, paginated reports are actually made using a new tool. And paginated reports are pretty much similar to this one, our tables and all. So, yeah, that is what is paginated reports are. Now, if you are a Power BI Pro license, you can't do paginated reports. Whereas with Power BI Premium and Power BI Premium per capacity, you can do this paginated reports. Now, consume content without a per user license. Well, I'll tell you what exactly is this one is. On-premises reporting with Power BI Report Server, there is something called as Power BI Report Server, which also you will get using Power BI Premium per capacity. Okay. Now, with that being said, all the data sets, okay, that you publish should be, each data set that you publish should be of 1 GB in Power BI Pro license. Okay. Now, each data set that you publish can be of 100 GB inside your Power BI Premium license. And each data set that you publish, if it is Premium license per capacity, it can be up to 400 GB. Okay. Now refresh rate. Now what does this refresh rate means? Now if your data lies inside cloud and if you don't choose to get your data using direct query, and if you choose the data in import mode, okay, the latest data still lies in the data source and it will not be inside your Power BI desktop, right? So for that you'll have to refresh to get the latest data, and this refreshing will happen only 8 times per day if it is Power BI Pro, and it happens 48 times a day if it is Power BI Premium. I mean, it can happen up to 48 times a day. You have the ability to choose it. Okay. Now for Power BI Premium capacity also, it has 48 per day. Okay. Now connect to more than 100 data sources. Everything offers a lot of data sources. Create visuals and reports with Power BI Desktop. Everything offers create visuals. I mean, this Power BI Desktop is actually free. You don't even need any Power BI service license, to be honest. Now, embed APIs and controls. You can do it with all these three. Okay, you can actually embed APIs. Okay, you can do API calling and all. I mean, you can code your APIs. That is what you can do. Okay, and then you have something called as AI visuals. Well, AI visuals are possible in all of them, and all the other options are only limited to these two licenses, which is premium per user and premium per capacity. Okay, now with that being said, there is something called governance and administration. Data security and encryption is possible in all three of them. Metrics is possible in all three of them. Metrics is like analysis on your reports. Okay. Analysis on your reports. How are people using it? Okay. What is the peak usage and all? Okay. All that can be done inside this metrics and all. Now, application lifecycle management can be done only in this two licenses, which is Power BI per user and Power BI per capacity. Okay. And a lot of other options. Now, apart from all these options, this is one more important option, which is maximum storage. Now this maximum storage for Power BI user for Power BI Pro license is for 10 GB per user. Okay, for this is 100 TB, and whereas for this is 100 TB. Now what does this mean? So each data set which you publish should be less than or equals to 1 GB. It can't be more than 1 GB if it is Power BI Pro license, right? Now at the same time, all the data sets together should not be more than 10 GB. Okay, that is what it is. Now each data set or each report, whenever you publish a report, a data set will be automatically generated. And data set is nothing but all the tables, all the data inside your tables together will form a data set. Okay. Now with that being said, now all the records inside a table together form a data set. And this data set size when you publish should not exceed more than 100 GB. Whereas here, the total of all the data sets together, all the reports and data sets together should not cross more than 100 TB. Okay. And the same is with Power BI per. Okay. Here it is 400 GB, and whereas it is 100 TB. Okay. So these are the different types of capacities which you have inside your Power BI. Now, this is the one which we haven't went through, right? So what happens is, let's say if users doesn't have any license. Now, usually what happens is whenever you create this Power BI reports and all, and you choose to share it, okay, you by default can only share it with users from your organization, users from your tenant. Okay, that is what you can do. Now, if you want to share it with users who doesn't even belong to your organization, and users who doesn't even have any Power BI license, okay, for that, you need this Power BI per premium capacity. Okay. And if you look back at over here, you have something called as embedded. Okay. Now, this embedded capacity is a capacity that is actually offered by Azure portal. Okay. Now, if I just go to my portal.azure.com. Okay. Now, if I just go to my portal.azure.com and if I just type in Power BI, now you will see that there is something called Power BI embedded. Okay. Now this is what is this embedded capacity is. Okay. Now you can use this embedded capacity and also make it live for every user out there. Okay. Now, what do I mean is this premium per capacity will allow you to make your reports available for all the users out there. Users from users outside of your organization. Okay. Users from users who doesn't even belong to your organization, users who are not even a part of your tenant, okay, users who doesn't even have any Power BI licenses, okay, everyone on the planet can access your reports with Power BI premium per capacity license. Now, embedded will also do the same, okay, whereas embedded will is a capacity that is there over here in Power BI in your Azure, okay, it's actually a service from Azure, okay. Now the thing is, if you look at it over here, see embed APIs and controls, this is what this one is, okay. With this, what you will do is this Power BI embedded, what you will do is you will actually embed APIs and all the controls, and also reports, dashboards and all to the end users, okay. Now with this, I mean, this embedding option, okay, this actually goes with your Power BI Pro license or Power BI Premium license or Power BI Premium per capacity license. Okay. So this is what, this is how embed Power BI works. Okay. Now what I'll do is I did not really create this. Now this develop a template app is something while we are actually working with, Power apps and all, you have few templates already, right? So similarly in Power BI also you have few templates, okay. Now you can actually create a template app as well just by clicking this button, okay. You can actually create a template app as well, and this will serve as a template for your organization or maybe for people out there, okay. So that is what this develop a template app means, okay. Now with that being said, we are actually good with all the details that we have given for our workspace, so we'll just click on save. So this will actually create a workspace for us, and this is the workspace that is there, okay. Now what you can do is you can actually directly upload reports as well, okay. You can directly upload PBX files, you can directly upload Excel, XS files, CSV files, and a lot of other things here, okay. You can directly upload data set, you can create a data set, okay. But apart from that, what we'll do is we'll just go back to our Power BI desktop, and from here we'll actually choose to publish the application. Now whenever you click on publish, it will ask you to save it, even though you have saved it earlier. It will ask you to save it again, okay. So you'll have to save it, and once you click on save, now it will ask you to choose a destination. Which destination do you want to publish this report to, okay. Now my destination is sales workspace, so this is the workspace which I want to publish the report to, and I'll just select this and click on save. Now once that is done, it will be published. Now once it is published, okay, now you will be having options. You can directly click on this and check the report inside your workspace, or you can directly open app.powerbi.com and you can see now that there are two things over here, okay. The first one is the report, whereas the second one is data set. Okay. Now, what exactly is this data set? This data set is the combination of all your tables. Okay. All your tables that you have done, right? All your tables you have created, right? All these tables along with data, if it is an import mode, well, it is an import mode because we have choose to use Excel sheets. So all this data will be from your data sets. Okay. Will form a data set once you publish it. So this is what your data set is. Okay. Now, apart from this, you have something called as a report. Now, if I just click on this report, you'll be able to see the report over here. Okay. You can apply filters over here as well. If the end user knows how to apply this Power BI filtering and all, the same filter pane which you have while creating a report, that is over here, and they can actually create filters as well. Now, with that being said, just see if you can apply filtering using the slicer. Yes, you are able to apply filtering using the slicer. Okay. Now hold control to select multiple options. You're able to apply the slicer, and you can as well. Okay, you can erase all the filters as well. So now let's just go back to our workspace. This is our workspace. Okay. Inside our workspace, we have three tabs, which is all content and data sets and data flows. Inside this data set and data flows, you'll be having all your data sets. Okay. If you go to this content, you'll be having all the content that you need for your Power BI service. I mean, all the reports and dashboards will be inside contents, and whereas data sets will be inside this. Okay. Now, and also you have something called as all. Inside that, you will find all everything, reports, dashboards, data sets and all. Okay. Now, with that being said, what you can do is now, if I just go here now, actually people can now that I've published this, now if I share it with anyone, now if I share this data set with anyone, people can actually create their own data sets. People can actually create their own reports and all. Okay. Using this data set, live query connection, which we have seen in our previous classes. Okay. Now with that being said, what else can people do on Power BI service is they can actually get data. Okay. They can actually get data from few resources. Now, if they just click on get data, and then if they click on my organization and then click on get, okay, they can choose, I mean, they can select all the apps, and these are all the templates that will actually, you can get data from. Okay. I mean, just like the templates which you have in your Power apps, these are all the templates, okay, which you can build your reports from. Okay. These are also all the templates which you can build your reports from, but you can actually filter them as well. Okay. And if your organization have any templates published, those will be viewed over here. Okay. So that is what this one is. Now you can actually get data from various services. Now this also opens up the same thing, which is templates. You have to install this application template app and you're good to go. Okay. Now with that being said, apart from this, you can actually get data from files and databases and also data flows. What exactly are data flows? Data flows are like your flows, or maybe from some other flows. Okay. So if I just click on this files, you can actually get from local file, OneDrive, SharePoint, and other files. And I can actually choose to go back here and click on databases, or it's the same thing. I mean, this is the file and this is the database. Okay. So these are the only databases that are available. Okay. So what you have to understand over here is the connectors which are given over here are very less. Okay. And that is the reason why it is always recommended that instead of using Power BI service, you can actually use Power BI desktop first. Now, what if you don't have a Windows operating system? And if your, Power BI desktop will only run on Windows operating system, right? If you don't have a Windows operating system, and if your data lies inside Azure SQL database, okay, then or any of the databases that are provided on the service, that are provided by the service, any other connectors that are provided by the service, let it be files or let it be databases, okay, you can actually connect to these files and get the data from there. Okay, directly you can create. Okay, now can we directly create report here also? Yes, once you connect to the data source here, you will be actually able to create reports as well over here. Okay, now if I just go back, okay. Now I'll just go back to here. Now this is our sales report, right? Now once I go to sales report, you can actually create your reports as well. I mean, you can actually change your reports, create your reports. You can do a lot of things. Let's just erase this. Yeah, you can actually create your own reports as well over here. Okay. And how can I prove you that? To prove you that, you have something called as edit button over here. And if I just click on this edit button over here, see, it's the same thing which you look at in your Power BI desktop. See, all the data, I mean, all the columns are also available now. Okay. So you can actually create reports over here as well. Okay. I mean, there are a lot of things that you can do from here as well. See, edit interactions, buttons. You can refresh the data here, duplicate this page and create a new page. Okay. And save this, pin this to dashboard. We'll see in it a while. Now you can say, click on this chat in Teams, which will open the Teams, this one. And you'll have to select a team chat, team or channel. And from there, you can actually, talk to the people about this particular report or dashboard inside Teams. Okay. Now, with that being said, you can actually do mobile layout, you can actually do reading view, you can actually view it in whatever way you want. Okay, you can see bookmarks, you can create bookmarks. Selection and bookmarks pane are also available. See, selection pane is available. Okay, bookmarks pane is available. Okay, so you can do bookmarks as well over here. Okay, that's one more cool feature. Now, you can actually save it as a different report once you make the changes or something like that. You can download this PBIX copy. Okay, you can embed this into SharePoint Online. Okay, embed it to a website or publish it to the web, but this needs your admin approval. Okay, export this into a PDF, export this into a PowerPoint. Okay, you can do a lot of things. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll just go back to my report. I'll not save it. Okay. Now, instead of actually changing that report, okay, you can actually make a copy of this report and change it. Okay. But before making a copy of it and changing it, what we will do is we'll go through all the options that are there over here. Okay. Now we have seen edit option. Now you actually have see related content, which will actually show the related content of this particular report and all. But if you just click on this, usage metrics will actually show metrics. It will actually load the metrics. Now, once you look at this metrics, it will show you like how many times how many views you are getting per day and all. Okay, unique views. It will also catch this session per user, so that you will also be able to understand how many unique views you are getting per day. Okay, so it is a analytics on your analytics, something like that. That is what is this metrics is. Okay, now let's just go back to our sales report and go through the other options. And you have something called a spin to dashboard, which we'll discuss, but apart from that, you have something called as lineage. If you just click on this open lineage view, now you'll actually be able to see how did you actually make your report. Okay, see, you got the data from the sales data.xlsx. okay, from that you have created something called sales report, and this sales report, this is nothing but a data source, data set. From this data set, you have created this sales report. Now, if I just click on this data set, it will show you all the tables over here as well. Okay, which is customer table. I mean, just the table and the schema, but not the this one. And also it will tell you the configure time, refresh time, when will it refresh next. Okay, all that. Okay. Now, with that being said, I'll just close this. Now, with that, you have created the sales table. Okay. Sales report. Okay. Now, just go back to your workspace. And inside your workspace also, you can actually view it in a list view, which is this one. Or you can actually view it in a lineage view, which will actually show you the same thing again. Okay. So, let's just stick to the list view for the time being. Okay. Now, if I just go back to my sales report, from the sales report over here, okay, that is what this lineage is. We have seen what exactly is editors. Now you can actually subscribe to a report as well. Okay, and you can actually comment on this report. Whenever you share this report with people can do commenting on this particular report, and you can also comment on them. You can talk about the reports and all. Okay, chat in Teams is the same option which I've showed you earlier. Now with this, you can actually share it with people. You can actually get the link, but this sharing option is only among your organization, that you have to understand. Okay, now apart from this sharing, you can just copy the link and share it, but apart from this sharing, what you can do is you can do something called as manage permissions. Now how did I get here? Click on this share, click on this three dots and click on manage permissions. Okay, now you can actually give direct access to people. Okay, so you can actually share it with email IDs from your organization or from your tenant. Okay, now you can actually select these check boxes. So allow recipients to share this report. Now whoever you share this report with, will they be able to share it with other users from your organization? Yes, if you want that to happen, you can allow this. Or allow recipients to build content with the data associated with this report. Do you want them to create reports? Yes or no? up to you. Now include my changes if you have any, if you had made any changes, okay, your changes will be included. Now send an email notification to them. As soon as you change, I mean, as soon as you share this report to your users, you'll send an email notification to them. Okay, that is what this grant access is. Okay, now no matter what, even if you give this copy, I mean, even if you link this, I mean, even if you give this link to users in your organization, okay, it's always better to do, I mean, share it with direct access as well. Okay, you have to give them this direct access as well, so that you have the command over this, all these things. Okay, now that's how it is. Now, apart from that, you can actually export them in various things. You can analyze in Excel. It will actually analyze the whole data inside Excel. Okay, but for this, you'll have to install a new application called Excel. Now, all the things which you analyze on your Excel in your Power BI service, what will happen is those will be actually stored inside something called as workbooks over here. Okay, inside your workspace, okay, you have dashboards, reports, and data flows and data sets and all, right? Now what happens is whatever you choose to analyze in Excel, those will be saved inside the workbooks of your workspace. That is what will happen. Now then you have file, save a copy, okay, download PBX file, the same PBX file which we have uploaded, that will be downloaded. You can print this page, embed this report in SharePoint online website or portal, or publish it to web. And for this, you'll need licenses, or you'll need your admin to give you access for this. Now, if I just click on this, it will tell that contact your admin for this. Okay. But apart from that, if I embed this report inside, I mean, you directly get this iframe element. You can embed this report inside a HTML page, but even then, it will be only visible to users from your organization and also users who have Power BI Pro licenses. Okay. Now, with that being said, you can actually generate a QR code. Okay, a QR code will be generated. You can share this QR code to people. Okay, it is also possible, and you have a lot of settings. Okay, sales report, description of it, who do you want to contact for this particular report. Now you can actually, we'll talk about this endorsement in a while, but yeah, filters, you can persist. I mean, do not allow end user to save the filters on this report. Filters will not be saved. Okay. And there are a lot of other options. Okay. So you can, I mean, while you're exporting the data, how do you want the data, summarized data or summarized data and underlying data? Okay. How do you want it? Okay. And a lot of other options. Okay. So that is what are there inside the settings. Now, this is the option where you can actually save a new copy of this particular report. Okay, so let's just click on this and let's just write it as sales report 2. Yeah, that is the thing which I want to write. So I'll just write it as sales report 2. Now, I'm inside my sales report 2. Now, I can actually, if I just go back to my workspace, you can see that there are two reports now, sales report and sales report 2. Now, sales report is the report which we have generated, which we have created on our Power BI desktop and published it on our Power BI service. Whereas sales report 2 is the report which we have copied it, made a copy from the existing report. Now I can actually go to the sales report 2 and I can actually now make changes. For example, if I go here now, okay, instead of this having a line chart, I can actually make it to this one, pie chart. Okay, so that I can do. Okay, now I can also make this background color change or something like that. Okay, so slicer header color is white, I can make it to black. That's one more thing which you can change. So these are the changes that you can actually make. I mean, we can make a lot of other changes as well, but yeah, I'm just fine with these changes. Now, once you are done with the changes, you will click on save. Now this will change your report to. Now we'll go to our sales workspace and we'll go to report one. Now this is our report one, which has only one page at the moment. Okay, we did not change anything over here. See, products is still in white and this is a line chart. Now, if I go to sales workspace back, if I click on sales reports 2, this will show me all the reports. See, new report. So this is what your report is. Now, what you can do is, now, once you actually create your data set and publish it, okay, there can be many changes that you want to do. Okay, let's just go back to our workspace. So we are back in our workspace. Now you can actually create a pipeline, but this pipeline at the moment is only available for premium per user license or premium per capacity license. Now these are nothing but your deployment pipelines. There will be three workspaces created, one for your development, which is this current workspace, and then the other workspace for testing, and then the last workspace for production. So you'll be directly sharing production links with people. Okay, so you can do a kind of testing and all with this create a pipeline option. Okay, now with that being said, you also have this view thing, which we have already seen it, where you can list you can choose to look at list, or you can click on lineage and directly look at all the lineages. See, now value report is also added. With that being said, you can actually change the settings. These are the same settings that are there earlier, but apart from that, you can actually change the license mode, and if you have any Azure connections and all, you can go through this. Okay, now apart from this, you can actually share your workspace directly with the people. Okay, like admin, member, contributor and viewer. Okay, these are the four options that are there. While sharing your workspace, directly the workspace, we are talking about workspace, not the underlying report or not the data source, data set. Okay, we're talking about the workspace, directly the workspace. And workspace has four options. Okay, admin, member, contributor and viewer. Okay, now what all these options do? Okay, that is from here. Let's just go back to here and paste the link. So these are the roles that are there in the workspace, which is admin, member, contributor and viewer. And admin can do everything in a workspace, whereas member cannot update and delete the workspace, cannot add or remove people, including other admins. Cannot add or remove people. And also this option. Okay. Whereas contributors have less options they can do in a workspace, whereas viewers has very, very less options. Okay, that is what these four roles are in your workspace. Okay, so let's just go back to our workspace. So this is our workspace. Okay, so what you can do right now is, there is something called as this data set, right? So if you just click on this data set, from here you can actually create report. From the same data set, you can create a new report. That is what I'm trying to tell you. Analyze this whole data set in Excel, and as soon as you analyze this data set in Excel in your workspace, under workbook, there will be a new Excel workbook that will be created, and that will be stored inside your Power BI service. Okay. Now once that is done, you can create a paginated reports, but paginated reports are only available for premium users. Okay, now paginated reports are pretty much similar to this one of tables. Okay, so with that being said, we have something called as delete. You can delete this. You can get quick insights. Now this is very handy feature. If you just click on this quick insights, this will actually generate quick insights, and it will take some time, and we'll see the other options that are there till then. You can rename this report. I mean, you can rename this data set. You can rename this data set as sales data set. Okay, save it. Okay, we have just renamed the data set. Now our insights are ready. So let's just go and click on view insights. Now these are the insights that are developed by Power BI artificial intelligence. Power BI service has an artificial intelligence that will actually develop tiles, develop visualizations by default for you just by clicking on the option view insights. Okay, and this happens on the data that you have. Okay, so see, this is how the data is. This is how it is created. Okay, now if you like anything, okay, you can actually view it. Okay, you can actually make it big, view it. Okay, focus mode. Okay, view it. Okay, and then pin it if you like it. Okay, but to pin this, you need dashboards and all, which we haven't discussed yet. But yeah, you can see that Power BI service artificial intelligence has created a lot of reports for you by default. I mean, a lot of visualizations for you by default. Okay, so let's just go back to our sales workspace, and there is something called as data set. So we are just going through all the options. Now you have something called a security. Okay, row level security, okay, can actually be configured over here. Okay, now with that being said, there is something called as download PBIX, which will download the PBIX. Again, the same option. Now, view lineage is the same option, which will actually do something like this. Okay, this one. Okay, now let's just go back. Now, with that being said, you also have manage permissions. You can manage permissions. You can give direct access to the workspace. I mean, just share the data set. So this is how you actually share the data set. Okay, now allow recipients to share this data set or just build content with this data set. Okay, that you can do. How do you share data sets with people? This is how you share data sets with people. Okay, now go back to this one. Let's just click on this. Okay, now once that is done, there is something called as settings. So we'll just go through all the settings that are there. Okay, so these are all the data set settings that are there. So if you have any parameters or something inside your data set, you can go through this parameters option. And then you can actually enable Q&A. By default, we enable. You can actually disable it if you want. No Q&A option. So if you have any featured questions, you can actually put them over here. Actually, you can actually get this Q&A directly from your Power BI desktop, or you can actually get this Q&A option from here as well. Okay. And then you have something called as endorsement. Now, whenever I click on this promoted and save this, what will happen is this particular data set when they are making live connection. Okay. Now this is what live connection is, right? Now this is not allowing me to live connection, but we have already seen what exactly is live connection in our previous classes. So whenever you actually promote it or whenever you make it certified, there are steps how do you make your data set certified. Okay, follow them if you want to make it certified. So what will happen is whenever they try to connect to the data set directly, now you can actually share your data set with people, right? So whenever you actually share this data set with people, whenever they try to connect, this will be, I mean, if it is promoted or if it is certified, this particular data set will be appearing at the top of the shared list for the user. Okay, that is what this promoted is. Okay, now with that being said, okay, you can actually change the access that is there for users. Okay, select how users will request permissions to access content from this data set. Okay. Okay, that you can play around with. And then you can have something called large dataset storage format. And this is only available for premium capacity. But at the moment, the best thing with this option is you can actually see the size of your dataset, which is nothing but 2 MB. Okay, so why is it 2 MB? Now, if I just go back here and if I just go to the data here, the sales table has 12,000 rows case. Okay, and this products table has 80 rows. And this location table has 35 rows. And this rows, I mean, this measure table has no rows, whereas this employee table has 80 rows and this customer table has 650 rows. So all this together has formed only 2 MB. Okay, so all this together has been compressed and formed only as 2 MB. Okay, but this option is available for premium users. So what they can do is they can actually if they own it, they'll get more performance and all. So that is what this one is. Okay, now you can actually change your data source credentials as well over here. Okay, this is disabled at the moment because our Excel sheet doesn't have any data source authentication and authorization. Okay, and that too, it's an import mode. Okay, that you have to understand. Now with that, you also have an option to upload an image for your data set. Now whenever you upload an image in your data set, that image will be populated over here. Okay, now let's just go back to settings. We have a few more things to discuss. There is something called a schedule refresh. Okay, now this schedule refresh is refreshing your data set and getting the latest data from your data source. Now if your data set is on cloud, if your data source is on cloud, okay, then you don't have to bother about the schedule refresh at all. Okay, I mean data will be automatically updated if it's a direct query. We have seen it, right? But if it's import mode, what happens is you have to manage the schedule refresh. But to manage the schedule refresh, you have to get your gateway connection on. Okay, for on that particular machine, you have to configure the gateway. Okay, now this gateway is the gateway which we have done when we are actually dealing with Power Automate. Okay, similarly, on the same machine, your machine itself will act as a gateway once you install your gateway on that particular machine. So first you have to establish this gateway connection, okay? And you, let's say if you have used your personal laptop, okay, you have to install gateway on your personal laptop, and then whenever you switch on that laptop, at that particular point of time, this option you can keep it as on, and at that particular point of time you can actually select the time, okay, at particular point of time, daily or maybe 1 hour. So it's always recommended that whenever you are actually using a import mode or something like that, create your visuals, I mean do all this Power BI thing on a virtual machine so that you can actually establish this gateway on a particular virtual machine and get things right. Okay, so that is all about the schedule refresh and gateway connections. Okay, so these are all the options that you have inside your data set. Okay, now if I just go back here to my workspace, okay, so these are the three things that are there, these are the things that are there over here. Okay, now apart from this, you can actually create dashboards and actually share these dashboards with people. Now what happens is, once you have created this data set, okay, you can actually share it with people. Now that we know that you can actually share it with people, a lot of people out there, okay, and also once you share it with people, there will be a lot of reports, right? Not just sales report, but also sales report 2 or maybe some other report by someone else, okay? So there might be a lot of reports. Now dashboard is something which is a collection of visualizations from multiple reports, okay? So dashboard, the definition of dashboard is, it is something that is a collection of visualizations from multiple reports or collection of pages from multiple reports, okay? So let's just go to our report, sales report 1, and I'll show you how do you create a dashboard, okay? So to create a dashboard, you will just have to click on this edit button, okay? Now once you click on this edit button, what you can do right now is you can actually choose a tile to pin on a dashboard. For example, let's just choose this line chart to pin on dashboard. So I'll just click pin over here, pin visual. Now this pin visual will actually allow us to create a new dashboard, okay? So here you don't have any existing dashboard, so there is no option, I mean, to select this. This option is grayed out. But apart from that, you have something called as new dashboard. So you can select a new dashboard and then just give a new name, which is sales dashboard, and click on pin. Okay, so now you have actually selected a dashboard and the dashboard has been generated. Okay, now if I just look at it over here, now here you will also have dashboard. Okay, so this is the dashboard. Now inside content, you'll see dashboards and reports, whereas inside data sets, you'll be only seeing data sets. Now if I just go to content and select this sales dashboard, see, this is the dashboard that is there, and dashboard can also be shared with people. Okay, now the difference between dashboard and a report, directly sharing a report, is now if you choose to share the dashboard, it doesn't have the filter panel which you get with reports. Okay, now if you click on anywhere on the dashboard, it will take you back to a report, and see, this is the filter panel that is there over here. So the advantage of this dashboard comes into the picture when you are actually trying to share this reports and all, embed this reports and all inside a website or something like that. Okay, now you can actually embed reports inside a website, you can actually embed dashboard inside a website. Now if you embed a dashboard inside a website, okay, people might not know this filter panel, okay, people will might not know this filter panel, right? Only Power BI developers mostly will be knowing this filter panel, and that is the reason why you are actually developing this slices and all. Okay, so you can actually directly share the dashboard rather than sharing the filter, so for this report, so that people will not have access to this filter panel or whatever it is, okay, and they can only go through the interactive dashboard. Now there is one more advantage of directly sharing dashboards. Now the advantage is, now let's say your team has created like multiple reports, okay, let's say like 20 reports or maybe 30 reports on your data set, okay, now you can actually pick the visuals which you want from multiple reports and put them inside one dashboard. Now what I mean is, this particular visual which we have over here, now I've got it inside my dashboard, right? This is my dashboard, right? Now I want another report from another visual, okay, from another visual from another report, okay? Now this also I want to put there. Now how can I do that? For that, you'll have to just click on this edit, okay, go here, pin it to the dashboard. Now you have this existing dashboard, you can get it over here. That's all, that is done. Now once it is done, you can actually choose to change it, I mean replace it wherever you want. You can change its size if you want it. Okay, you can increase the size, you can decrease the size. Okay, it's up to you. Okay, now apart from these two, what you can do is you can go back to your this one. Okay, ask Power BI service to create a lot of reports. So these are the reports that are created by Power BI service, right? Which I've already shown you earlier. If you like any of the reports from here, what you can do is you can actually get this reports into your dashboard as well. Okay, maybe this report into your dashboard as well. Okay, see, and if you go back to your dashboard, see, you have all the reports inside your dashboard. Okay, now you can actually share this with your dashboard with people. Okay, now each report, now each tile over here has separate settings as well, which add comments, chat in Teams, copy, visual as an image. Okay, you can copy it as an image. Okay, now you can paste it wherever you want. Export to CSV. All the data from this particular visual will be exported to CSV. You can open this in a focus mode, which we already know. Okay, now apart from that, you also have edit details. I mean, if you want, you can edit the details, name and all. Okay, now if you have premium licenses, you can actually create a new URL. You can actually append a new URL for this particular report, I mean particular tile. Okay, that is also possible. Now you can actually view insights. I mean, if you click on this again, this filter pane will be coming up, and also apart from that, people will be actually again be looking at a lot of other visuals and they can pin it. Okay, now these are all the options that are there for a particular tile. Okay, you can delete the tile as well. Okay, now with that being said, your dashboard also has features. Now your dashboard by default gets a Q&A feature. Okay, now you can choose not to have this Q&A feature. For example, count locations will give me the locations. Okay, count customers will give me the customers. Now this Q&A can be configured from your Power BI desktop or can be configured from here. Inside the settings over here, we have this Q&A, right? Q&A and this one. Sorry, this one, featured questions, featured Q&A questions. Okay, both the places. But it is always good to do it on Power BI desktop. Let me just refresh it. I'm actually able to see something which is disturbing. Yeah. So let's just go back to our dashboard. So dashboard actually allows all this. Okay. And you can now share the dashboard with people. Now people can actually comment on the dashboards. Okay. That is one thing. Okay. Maybe something like this. This is a sales dashboard which has very good visuals. Maybe this is what I've commented. Now people can actually comment on this, or maybe they can choose a new reply, whoever you share this dashboard with. Okay, now people can subscribe to this dashboard. Whenever there are changes, they will be notified or something like that. Now you can actually edit dashboard by adding a new tile. If you want, you can add a new tile from this, from different options over here. Okay, the tile can be a video or an image or text box, web content or something like that. Okay, or you can change the dashboard theme. You can change it to black. See, the dashboard, whole dashboard theme is now changed to black. Look at this, looks so good, right? Now what else you can do is dashboard theme, you can actually upload JSON themes. Okay, that is also possible. You can download this JSON theme and use it wherever you want, I mean inside your Power BI desktop or something like that. Or download this JSON theme and use it in some other dashboard. Make it colorblind friendly, okay? For colorblind people, okay? Directly this option will make it available for them. And also you have something called as custom, where you can actually choose a background image and, you know, background color and blah, 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 and so on. All. I mean, you can do all that, okay? I'll just put it in dark because I liked this dark mode. Okay, now apart from this, you have this options where you can see the related content, lineage, and the same things again. Okay, that are there inside report. Now you can comment, you can chat in Teams, that's the same thing again. And then you have something called as file, which will be save a copy, will create a new dashboard, and again you can change, make changes on that particular new dashboard, which you already know. Print this page, you can print this. Okay, see, you can print this. Okay, maybe we have to change the option. Okay, maybe we have to make it to landscape or something so that we can see all the reports. Yeah, see, all the reports, you can print it now if you want, or save it as a PDF as well if you want. Okay, and apart from that, you have dashboard settings as well, where you can set this dashboard, I mean name of the dashboard, owner, okay, and promote this dashboard. You can actually promote this dashboard inside your home page, okay. And Q&A, you can off this Q&A. If you just switch it off, you'll not be able to find this Q&A anymore. Comments, you can switch it off comments as well, okay. Dashboard tile flow, let Power BI automatically arrange the tiles on this dashboard. I mean, if you just click on this, Power BI will automatically arrange the tiles instead of you arranging the tiles, okay. Click on save and see what all the changes we'll have. I've removed Q&A, so there shouldn't be Q&A now. Just in case if you don't want your users to use Q&A, you can just switch it off from your dashboard, okay. So these are all the options that are there inside your dashboard. Now what is important takeaway from here is, see, Q&A is already been done. Now you are, can you still do it? Okay, yeah, you can still do arranging and all, but Power BI will automatically arrange. Even if you don't do that, without this option also, Power BI will automatically do the style flow for you, okay. But it is always better for you, better that you do all this, okay. Now apart from this, if you just go back to your home page, see, this is featured now on your home page, okay. So directly from home page, as soon as they log in, they can click on that button and come to this dashboard and try to understand things, okay. Now apart from this, there are two things which you, I mean, there is one more thing from a dashboard which you have to understand. Let us go to our sales workspace for that. Okay, sales report, and let's just grab this one. I want this one, so let's just pin this one, pin this particular visual to our sales dashboard. Okay, we have done, we have pinned it to our sales dashboard. You can actually create a mobile layout from this also. Okay, from here also you can do this mobile layout thing, okay. As soon as you pin things, they are saying that you can do this mobile layout thing, right? So that also you can do over here. Let's just place it over here only, which is fine, okay. Now from this, from few visuals, what you can get is, you can actually get some alerts. For example, if I just click on this, see, there should be a place where I should get the alerts. Pin tile, this tile is already pinned. I mean, if you click on this pin tile option, it will be pinned to another dashboard if you want any other dashboards, okay. Go to report, open in focus mode, copy visual as image, chat in teams, manage alerts. Yeah, this is the one. So you can actually set alerts. Now you can actually set an alert where the total revenue, if it crosses for, like, let's say, more than the above value. Okay, the current value is like, let's say, what is the current value? Don't say. 139707, right? You can make it 140000, okay. If it crosses more than that, then you will be notified, okay. So if it crosses more than this, you will be notified, okay. And the frequency, how many, I mean, how many times you have to be notified in a day, or if you want to notify in an hour. Now do you want the notification only in Power BI? Okay, if you want the notification only in Power BI, then you have to uncheck this one, which is send email to. But if you want the email also, okay, if you want to have an email as well, then you have to select this option and then say, click on save and close, okay. So these are all the things that you can do on a dashboard, but these particular kind of manage notifications, manage alerts and all can be only done on few visuals like KPI cards or KPI goal chats. You have a chart in Power BI Desktop, which is this one. Let me just go here. Gotch, okay, which is used for attaining goal. If you want to do some goals, and I mean, if you want to go get some goals and all, then yeah, you can do that. Now with this, there is a problem, guys. See, this one is in black color now. Maybe you want to go back to your report and make this color as white. Now what I mean is, let me just open it in a focus mode. Open it in a focus mode. See, this one is black, right? So it is not able to, we are not able to visualize it over here. So you'll have to take care of all that, okay. So I mean, if you just look over here, you don't have that manage alerts option, okay. Yeah, So this is how you actually share details with, I mean, this is how you actually publish all the changes to Power BI service. And once you publish all the changes to the Power BI service, you can actually share details. I mean, you can actually choose to share dashboards, you can actually choose to share data sets, you can actually choose to share reports. It's totally up to you. But if you want to share it to people outside your organization or free users, you have two options. One is you going for premium license, which is very costly, premium capacity, which is very costly, $4,995. Okay. Or the other one is you using Power BI embedded. Okay. So I've told you in portal.azure.com, we have something called Power BI embedded, right? So if I just go to this Power BI embedded, let me just open this Power BI embedded option. Now, as soon as, I mean, whenever you choose to create this Power BI embedded, I'll show you that this is also not less cost. I mean, this is also very, very, very costly. Okay, yeah, this is the place where you'll see the cost. Okay, now this cost depends on the place where you're from. Okay, if your place where your tenant is located. Okay, if your tenant is located inside India, okay, you'll get this in rupees. Okay, if your tenant is in US, you'll get something like this. But the advantage of having Power BI embedded over Power BI desktop is, I mean, over Power BI premium per user is, first, Power BI premium per capacity is very costly. Okay, that's the first reason. And then the second reason is, even though the cost is very high, I mean, even though the cost shows very high, very high over here, okay, you'll only be cost, I mean, the cost will be only applied for the time this resource runs. Okay, now what I mean is, once you create the resource, let me just look at the, where do I have it here? Okay, now once you create the resource, you can actually you actually have an option to start and pause it, start and stop it. Okay, now the time for which the resource is running, only for that particular time you will be billed. Okay, and not for the other time. Now this embedded, you can use it with any other license which you have. Like you can use it with pro license. See, embed APIs and controls. You can use it with pro license. It is there in pro license. It is there in per user license and per capacity license. Now for capacity license, you will get all these enhanced options. Like you can go to 100 TB and you can do this 400 GB of publishing and all. You can do all this. But if you don't want all that, okay, and if you want only this one, okay, and if you want, I mean, by default Power BI compresses your data very, very good. Okay, now if your data even has like million records, okay, it will like maybe it will occupy like 20 MB or maybe 30 MB, okay, inside your 1 GB, which is 1000 MB, it will occupy around like 20 or maybe 40 MB or something like that. Okay, I mean, I have already shown you, I mean, the sales record has actually been occupied for 2 MB only, right? So similarly, something like this. Okay, so what you can do is, so cost effective solution, you can give a cost effective solution to your organization by taking Power BI Pro license. And if your organization want to make it available for everyone, even the free users out there, you have to use this, I mean, this one, Power BI embedded capacity. Okay, Power BI embedded capacity. And this Power BI embedded capacity, even though it shows that it is very costly, okay, it will only be charged when it is running, and it is not charged when it is not running. Okay, it is not charged when it is not running. That is what this premium capacity, I mean, this Power BI Azure service does for you. Azure Power BI service, which is Power BI embedded. Okay. Now, how do you work around this? I mean, how do you make it? How will you make this Power BI embedded work? Okay, how will you create this resource? Okay, how do you write all the APIs? Okay, how do you make all the reports available to everyone on the planet? Okay, now for that, I've already covered all that in a YouTube session, which we have done previously for Azure conference. So you can actually go through this YouTube session. Okay, you can actually go through this YouTube session, okay, which I have covered earlier. And yeah, That link will also be available inside this document, and this document will be shared with you. So this is how, I mean, you can actually go through everything over there. Okay, now the reason why I'm not going through all that is I have to talk about APIs, I have to talk about development and all. And a lot of you might not know what exactly is an API and what exactly is how do you get the C# code. And also you might not know a lot of frameworks. Okay, so you're not going through all that, but this is where you have to take care of your developer, you along with your developer in your organization together. Okay, will actually be able to create this Azure service, which is Power BI embedded, and make reports available even for the free users, even for the users who doesn't have any Power BI license, and also the users who doesn't even belong to your tenant. Okay, so that is all about Power BI service. Thank you.